Tuesdays It Takes Two on BBC Two, and I play her. We are just 4 days away from the final of Strictly Come Dancing 2023, and we just can't stop giving you what you want as we get closer to the grand finale. Here's what's coming up tonight. We welcome our first set of finalists, Bobby and Diane, who dodged Dance of Disaster at the weekend by a whisker. We'll be asking them about all three of their routines for this year's final. The Malice is back with one last masterclass. Today, we'll be finding out what makes a Viennese waltz perfect with the help of Neil Jones. And he's been totting up the couple scores, and he's got more stats and facts than Florence Nightingale. See, we're educational too. OJ Borg will be giving us his end of series rundown very shortly. But first, what links an ice cream machine, a hot cross bun, balloons, a heavy coat, a hand puppet, and a tuna sandwich? No, it's not the rider for the Strictly Rap Party. They're all Joanne Clifton analogies. Shall we see what she's got for us today? Oh, hi. You just caught me trying to crunch the numbers from this series. What did Bobby get for his waltz again? Does anyone know how many 40s Leighton has? I'm gonna need some help with this. There's only one person for the job, and it's OJ Borg. Oh, yeah. Here to give us another dose of deja, it's the one and only OJ Borg.
Hey, I say stats, you say? That's right.
Is that your mate? That
he just says stats for
It makes sense. OK, first things first. 6 weeks ago, you predicted our final three would be Leighton, Ellie and Bobby. Have you got a lottery ticket tonight? What are you doing?
Well, as a former face of the balls, I can neither confirm nor deny that I have a lottery ticket, but I think you'll find in the numbers in a second why I thought they were going to be the final three.
OK. Yeah. Well, we've gone from 15 to three. What have you noticed about our finalists this year?
Well, first up, a quick mention of our pros. We are going to have a new pro winning Strictly this year. None of them have ever won it before. On to our celebs. Let's take a look at the total scores. Are you feeling hungry? Do you fancy a pie?
I am.
Well, have a pie chart. Here we go. Here's my pie chart. Ah. Here we go. So, Leighton and Akita, you can see their points there. 4, 6, 9, which is massive. It's a whopping score. In second place so far, this part of the pie down here, the red part, Ellie and Vito, 4, 5, 8. 4, 23, Bobby and Diane, little bit further behind.
Oh, that's impressive. I like your pie.
But let me just put this into context for you. Last year's winner, Hamza, went into last year's final, top of the leaderboard, 4, 5, 3 points, which was strong, but would only put him in third place this year. That shows you how strong it's been.
Interesting. OK, so where do our finalists' strengths lie?
Well, let me take you to my leaderboard, and it is my ballroom leaderboard
for you,
Fleur. Thank you very much. Now, this is your waltz, your Viennese waltz, your foxtrot, your tango, your quick step. Now, Ellie and Leighton, let's take a look at their scores. Absolutely the same. 33.3, 33.3. Just over a point behind. I won't use my GCSE in math to try and work it out because I keep getting it wrong. But we find Bobby and Diane. But here's a point for you. He does now have the highest scoring ballroom dance of the series after the weekend. That amazing quick step, he got a 38 for it.
OK, so what about Latin?
You want my Latin leaderboard?
I do.
Well, let me introduce you to it just here. This is your cha-cha, your samba, your paso, your jive and your rumba. Again, it is, well, it's sort of super close. You've got Leighton Nikita, 35.6. A few points be five, absolutely almost tied. We've got Ellie and Vito and Bobby and Diane. So it's pretty much neck and neck there.
OK, and the rest of the dances are what we call speciality dances. Can you just explain what those are and how everyone's got on with those?
Sorry, you want my speciality leaderboard?
Yes.
Well, here we go. So this is the couple's choice, the Charleston, the American Smooth, the Argentine Tango and the Salsa. This is where Ellie is the strongest, highest average of 38.4.
Wow.
That's the average. Leighton just behind her, 38.2. Bobby, a little bit further away, still respectable on 32.4.
Okay, I like it. What about tens?
Oh.
All of our finalists this series have had tens, but how do they break down?
Okay, here's my bar graph. What you said, Leighton, let's call him Leighton because he had so many 20 tens, two perfect 40s. They've never had a 10 for ballroom, though. No. See, yellow ballroom, no yellow. Ellie, 14 tens, no yellow. Still hasn't had a 10 for ballroom this series. And remember, the American smooth doesn't count. Bobby, though, he's got a bit of yellow. There we go. The only celeb with a 10 for ballroom. Also got two for his couple's choice.
OK, shall we take a look at them individually?
Oh, Bobby with the smile, our youngest contestant, Bobby. Second youngest ever Strictly finalist. Look at the moves. No body hair below the eyebrows. I still don't know if that's true or not. Now, after the weekend, Bobby has been in the dance-off the most of any of the finalists. That is twice. The last person to win the glitter ball after winning two dance-offs was...
Joanne.
Yes, it was. Aurea Duber and Joanne. Clifter back in series 14.
Go, so Clifter.
That proves it can be done. Let's take a look at this roller coaster graph, which, if it was a roller coaster, it'd be pretty boring because it ends up higher than where it started. Now, he's only, and I say only, got up to 38. I mean, this is still only 38. It's the lowest of the three finalists, but he's been incredibly consistent from week one all the way through to week 12. And if you look after week two, he hasn't dropped below a 30. That's how good he's been. If Bobby takes home the trophy, he'll become the youngest ever Strictly winner at 20. At the moment, if we look at the youngest ever winners, the youngest so far is Lewis Smith, who was 23 when he won.
OK, let's move on to another Strictly young gun. It's Ellie.
Oh, yes, she is. Well, we've had Queens of Hearts. Let's have Queens of Nines.
Really?
She's had 21 nines this series, the most of any celebrity. Wow. And here is another one of my roller coaster graphs. Here we go. Let's take a look at it. Look at that line graph. It's amazing. She hasn't dropped below 35 since week four. I mean, that almost, you could take it out of context and say it's a 28. She's come close to that perfect score on a couple of occasions. We look here, a 39 here and a 39 here. Here's a good sign for her. Only four winners in Strictly history have gotten a perfect 40 before the final in 21 series. That is Abby Clancy, Caroline Flack, Kelvin Fletcher and Rose Ayling Ellis. Now, Ellie is on track to become the highest scoring contestant aged 25 or under. Remember being 25 or under? I don't either. No, I don't. So let's take a look at this. This is a graph of the score so far. 4-5-8 for Ellie. Frankie on 4-5-5, 4-5-2 for Molly. And Jay had 4-3-5. Tiny caveat, this doesn't include Frankie's fifth guest judge score or the dance-a-thon scores. Ellie's currently leading going into the final. To keep that top spot, she needs to score 114 in the final on Saturday.
Oh, gosh, what's all going on? What about Leighton?
Oh, OK, let me talk to you about Leighton. Now, he has the same number of tens as he does nines. That is 20 tens and 20 nines. Whoa. Do you want to see his graph?
Yes!
Let's see his graph. Now, he has been on the top of the leaderboard seven times this series. Amazingly, over half of the weeks. His average score, and this is the average score all the way through, is 36. He is right up there with the all-time top scorers on Strictly. Let's have a bar chart. Now, this, again, doesn't include the dance-a-thon scores, but you can see where he sits. After the semi-finals, Alicia, 472. Ashley was on 471. Leighton, just a couple of points behind, on 469. And then Kelvin was on 465. Now, can he make Strictly history on Saturday? Well, the answer is, unless Cray's got a 12 paddle up his top, which I don't think he has, he cannot, because Ashley got three perfect 40s in the final. So even if he does the same on Saturday, he cannot beat her. But, here is the but, he can become the second highest ever scorer on Strictly. He'll go above Alicia if he scores 116 points in the final.
Okay, and breathe. Thank you so much. You've once again outdone yourself.
Thank you so much, Stats.
OJ Borg.